This is our first view of Schönbrunn Palace. This is the big country palace of the Hapsburgs. Hofburg was their main in the city ruling zone, but this was their getaway home. Of course, it's hard to think of it as country now, like it used to be, because the city has expanded so much in the last couple hundred years. It is already blistering hot, but time to go to the palace. Shoes are half women, half lion or something, or are they just reclined women? I think they're sphinxes or something, satyrs. Can't tell if it's horse or lion. First thought was lion because it was lions at the front there. Ticket center. All right, we have about a 25-minute wait till we can tour the castle. But there's all kinds of, this puts Neues Palais in Sanssouci. Now Sanssouci is very cool, but this is bigger. Now the layout at Nymphenburg outside of Munich was longer, but this is bigger. This is just a massive complex. And this specifically has stay off the grass signs. Mm-hmm. Now sadly, in the old days, this would have been much more grass. I don't know why they don't go back to it, probably because they need so much trucking and delivery, but they really could create a lane. But that's the sad thing. This would have been more grass, more, like you see the old stone path there. Mm-hmm. There would have been much more grass and flower and gardens here. And they just never redo them. I don't know why. You're kidding. You're kidding. Really? Yep. Okay, we just ended our inside tour. You're not allowed to film or photograph. It was really cool. Now it is, to do the full tour, it was 29 euros, which is a lot of money, but you did see a lot. And it paid for the upkeep of this, and actually some of the money still goes to the Hapsburgs, because they technically still own some claims to this land. But the thing is, they have multiple places that you have to pay to get in on these grounds. That's what kind of sucks. We paid 29 euros just to go through the palace. And then, oh, you want to go see the Royal Carriage Museum? Well, that's another 12 or 15. I forget what it is. Oh, you want to go into this place and see that? Oh, that's another charge. And they really need to just have a basic charge. They make plenty of money. They can afford to, you know, like 25 euros, see everything. And 20 euros if you want to just see it. But instead of, oh, 15 euros here, 29 euros here. Oh, we're out of the shade so you can feel the heat go. But now we're entering the gardens. And you can't even call it nickel and diming because it's 10, 15 euros, 20 euros. So I'd like to have gone and seen the royal carriages, but after 29 euros each to do the whole palace.
You're out with the boys.
All right. Alright, you want to go to the Grand Allée and walk the middle?
Sure.
Okay. Alright, so we're going to walk up here. I won't film the whole thing. Typical, all sorts of Roman, Greek god statues. But we're heading here to the Grand Allée, the main palace. I don't know if we'll succeed, but I'm thinking of walking all the way up to the Oranienburg up here. Now, there are two maze of gardens here, sort of like Sanssouci in Potsdam. Okay, are we
up the stairs and you're
good? No, I think right here is good. Okay. The question is, do you want to hike up to that? Okay, so we are going to hike up there and then we're going to look back across to the palace from there. I don't know that I will videotape a lot on the way. Videotape, film a lot on the way. Are we gonna walk down the middle or do you wanna hit to the sides and stay in the shade a bit? Pardon? Oh, there's paths that way that go up the side that are all shaded through there. So it's up to you. Video. And I'm gonna get you and me if we can. So we're staying in the shade. It is a blistering hot day and you can already see Schönbrunn Palace here. Really nice. All right. We are at Schönbrunn Palace. Well, it's in Vienna now.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think of the inside of the palace?
Mm, it's very cool.
Cool. Whoops. Trying to get us both in. There we go. And then if we turn around, we are heading up. We're heading up there. This is too cool. Now, like Sanssouci, Oh wait, is that it? No, this is the Neptune Brunnen in the way, and then you just have these other, the famous Neptune Brunnen, which is right there. I've wanted to see that. I can't tell you how long I've wanted to see this fountain. That is. The famous Neptune Brunnen. And then you got the Vienna Zoo is over there, the Tiergarten. There it is, the Neptune Brunnen, Neptune's fountain. I am finally here. We're not that far from the palace, so you get a great view of the palace. The beautiful flower gardens. And then Neptune Palace, and then we got to walk up the hill to get to that observation point. Whew. Oh yeah. You better believe I'm going up there. You can already feel the air temperature drop about 8 to 10 degrees right here. Just get a little bit from the side. But yeah, I'm going up and inside. This is too cool. And yeah, you can see the garden and the park again. But you can actually go behind the water. We're about a third up the hill, but this is kind of a cool view of the palace, but also Munich in the background, the temple back there. Let's stay off the grass sign. Joyce is enjoying the wildflowers here, which is great. But yeah, eventually we'll get to a point where you can see some of the other famous churches. There we go. You can see the Parliament building way in the distance back there. And you can see one of the towers from the Stephan's Dome. And as we get further up the hill, we'll probably see more. So let's find out. There we go. See some of the towers, some of the other palaces. That's Belvedere out there. Sadly, we're just not going to get to Belvedere. Belvedere is another Hofburg Palace in Vienna. It was their small in-town castle palace. But oh well, we only had 2.5 days, and they've been the 2.5 hottest days, both of our trip to Germany and in Vienna. They have had a massive heat wave hit. So here we're reaching this. So we're not up there yet, but we're 100 meters away. And then there's a glorious view over Vienna, the city we have. There's St. Michael's way in the distance with those two short white towers. And then St. Stephen's. Looking down on the palace below, the hills, the mountains, the other palaces. Straight down the main alley here. All right. Man, those are mammoth little statues. You see things very similar, but a third that size at Sanssouci and Neues Palais. But these are huge. The eagle up there. Yeah. And one last look over. Yeah, that lady took a tumble, didn't she?
Yes, she did.
I got it on video. I mean, I was just filming this way. I was filming you.
Right.
Yeah. No, I'm not going to put it out there.
No,
how you doing?
Good.
Big cafe inside here. What time is it?
1:34.
A little too early, unless you feel like you've earned. I'm sick of this camera just randomly turning off. All right, we are at the Hofburg Palace again, and we're here to see the Hapsburg jewels. Although why this is here, I don't know why this is here, but this is what I'm specifically here to see. Watch this. Thank you. that's the coronation roads for Lombardy and Venezia. So every time they got crowned, they had different things they were kings of. This stupid thing stopped recording again. I have no idea where. It's a painting of the election and crowning of the king, the emperor, I should say. This is for the King of Bohemia, because the Hapsburgs had that as well. And there's Matthias, the guy who started the 30 Years' War. Lasted a whole 3 years, and then was executed. A christening set for one of Maria Theresa's children. And another christening set. Hungarian crown, which they took when they is worn by different emperors. So up here, pendants for the four gospels. And this is Order of the Golden Fleece. diamond-encrusted sword presented as a gift from the Turkish Khan. This was all jewelry for the Empress Charlotte of Mexico when her husband Leopold was made Emperor of Mexico briefly. Huh? Really? Somebody else is there. These are all awards and medals given out by Maria Teresa. It's a narwhal tusk. Yeah. I was just into calling it a unicorn horn, and I said it's probably from a narwhal.
Seen the girl.
think something's missing. That's supposed to be right here, but it's missing. What? Claiming to be the sword of Charlemagne, but well after his time. Well, the one thing I came to see here is not here. Seeing these things, they're impressively made, but we've got 80 of them here. of stuff for the Hofburg Palace. Chain for the Knight of the Golden Fleece. Investment clothes for liturgical vestments. Going down to the Danube. I just wanted to come down and see the Danube. So even this isn't the original Danube. They changed its course a couple of centuries ago. The original Danube's way over there. We're under a highway here. You can feel this place shaking. This is the toy shop in Vienna. If you're into model trains and you find yourself in Vienna, this is the place to come. What a great shop and very nice people. It's a full toy store. It's not just model trains, but the second floor is trains.
Yeah, a great selection of Märklin and Pico.
Märklin, Pico, Fleischmann. They had old stock, new stock, stuff you wouldn't find anywhere else.
Yeah.
But
cool store.
Oh yeah, it is very cool. And yeah, they closed at 6,
okay.
Which is what I knew they did, but just to come back.